Hang on just so I can see everybody, and I'm going to give the call to David Clendon.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. A good choice. Sir, I just wanted to make a few brief comments on this part of the bill, because it is a very significant part. It's quite technical in a way, it's quite detailed, but essentially within this part we are told by what means, by what mechanisms people will have their rights reduced, people will have their opportunities to participate reduced. To what extent and by what means will be ordinary members of the public be denied their usual access to decision-making about events, activities, structures, facilities and so on, which actually could influence them in their day-to-day lives. And of course there are some quite substantial mechanisms, provisions put in place in this part, and all in the name of the World Cup and getting a good event. And yes, we all do look forward to that and hope it goes well. And also that we might leverage off this event to the maximum amount available. And that's a point I will return to. But initially, having made the point that this is the nitty-gritty, this is where we are told how the authority served by the Secretariat or the numerous secretariats will diminish people's rights, take away our access, our right to participate. But essentially, in a sense, this part is almost redundant because the...
aware of what the member was saying.
Absolutely.
I'm pleased.
David Clendon.
thank you, Mr. Chair. To an extent, this whole part is almost superfluous because the sting in the tail, if you like, is that no matter what decisions are made at this level, no matter who informs those decisions, by what means they are made, ultimately one person will have the say-so in terms of what may or may not occur. And that is the one step too far that has clearly brought Labor onto the side of opposing this bill, where the Greens have been from day one on this bill. Indeed it is, but I'm sure we have had reference to that already. Just a couple of quick examples as to some of the diminished ability people will have to participate. The matter of public notice, which has been commented on earlier. The information supporting documentation about particular applications may be limited to being placed on one website. Potential submitters, people wishing to make submission, may be obliged to only make submission through electronic means. And for many people that will not be a problem. It's a commonplace. But we must recall that not every household in New Zealand has access to electronic media. Not everybody chooses to use that form of communication. And I think we should be respectful of the choices or of the ability people have to make submissions. It's interesting that the matter of standing is addressed in this part, that standing will be needed to be proved. We're basically going back to the bad old days of the town and country planning, where not everybody had standing as of right, which is generally the rule under our new resource management approach. It's required that a person must have an interest greater than that of the general public to which the matter relates. There are various statements about affected persons and statements that the authority, for example, when it's considering what constitutes an adverse effect, must ignore effects of a temporary nature, which means numbers of people, communities of people, could be subjected to significant noise over a period of days and weeks without any opportunity of objecting to that because they are deemed to be temporary, and I think that's just not acceptable. I mentioned earlier that the justification underpinning a lot of these conditions is that this event is going to put New Zealand on a world stage. The various mechanisms, the various provisions in this part are there because it's some argument implied about the greater good for the country. It's interesting that in 2005, when the Cup was first awarded to New Zealand, we were told amongst great rejoicing that we estimated some 60,000 visitors would come to New Zealand, extra visitors. Now that That's a very debatable claim in itself, given that very robust European research demonstrates that most often the expectation about extra visitors from an event are overstated. In this instance, we saw 60,000 people expected in 2005. Today we're expecting 85,000 people. The expectation is inflated by some 40% in 5 years. In 2005, we understood that 3.4 billion people would witness this extravaganza on television. Now it's gone up to 4 billion people. Every one of the intervening 5 years, another 120,000 people, million people, have an interest in rugby. Mr. Chair.
Nikki Kaye.